Hello, welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today I'm going to be installing underfloor heating all over this house here, and we're going to be doing it for a few days. Scotty's going to be coming in to help me if you've seen him on our Snapchat or our Instagram. Enjoy, watch. We're going to be laying this one in this video, series of videos. Enjoy, subscribe, hold tight.
Plumberparts.co.uk, honest reviews and advice.
So guys, I hope you like my braces. Ooh, caught my nipple. Anyway, what we've got here is the actual schematic layout of these rooms. We've got a kitchen here, living room through there, and we've got a utility and a hall as well. So what we need to do first is actually go around and make sure that all these areas are insulated. I've got a feeling Scott's just turning up right now. Scott, what do you think? It's like my braces, the ledge, aren't they? So yeah, we're gonna be doing that right now. Hope you enjoy the rest of this video, guys. Remember to subscribe, like I just said. Oh my God, hold tight. So then first thing is, Scott is basically going around here and he's putting insulation on the internal walls, just under there. Already the builders have been very nice and they've put Celotex or whatever, you know, commercial type of insulation all around the outside walls already. Because mainly in my experience, the blue stuff doesn't tend to be as good as the Celotex, doesn't have as good a thermal efficiency. Also, Mark, was very kindly, he's the owner of the house, has marked out with tape all the areas where we don't want underfloor heating, because these are gonna be cupboard areas here. We've got a nice big butler area here. And you know, we don't really want that sort of area to be heated up, because you know, you've got stuff in cupboards, food like that. We've covered it in another video already. So Scott's gonna be laying that. Once he's done that, we can then lay out our tracking. A special tracking system for what we're using today. It's Buteline, and you basically lay the tracking out, a nice long strip, and then also we will be drilling our holes through our walls to take our pipes, because we will be having different loops, like the kitchen, for example. I think it's got three loops in it, and then basically it is going to be a matter of laying down pipe hell for leather, all right? Because I need to get this done today. First fix, actually, for the rest of the house, we've already done. If you look through here, we've done some filming in here already, so we've got our first fix down there. This is a utility room. This is where our cylinder's gonna be. You saw us do that bit of 4-inch. And then also, this is where our manifold is gonna be back here, and our boiler is gonna be up there. Scott has never, ever, ever laid underfloor heating in your life, have you, Scott?
No.
No, right? And in a way, this video is gonna be testament as to how easy it is to do, because it isn't hard. All you have to do is follow a plan. Like, I sent the spec for this lot to Buteline. They come back, you get a quote for everything, including controls, manifold, the actual runs and everything. They spec the pipe runs, and then they send you out a map, okay? And the map looks a little bit like lush. So here is our map right now. It looks remotely terrifying when you first really look at it, but then, I mean, I'm currently crouched here. So we know that we've got 1, 2, 3 loops going in and around the living room. We've got one loop going all around here, and then we've got, looks like we've got another 3 loops going all around the kitchen. As you can see, they're all colour-coded, so they're easier for you to see. And then you've actually got marked out on the manifold which ports they're going to be in. And then also it'll tell you which flow rates you want and all that, and the tube length as well. So you'll be able to completely sort out everything on this. So it should be pretty easy. So that's it. All you need to do is follow that guideline. So then, guys, we've got all the tracking down here now. Scott's laying down as well, aren't you, Scott? Now, what we're going to do is actually just lay our pipe out, okay? Right then, guys, so we've got loads of the underfloor in. We've also laid down protective membrane. It's almost the thickness of kind of sandwich bag plastic. Some people say, oh, it's gonna affect the heat transfer into the screed. Well, I tell you now, it's a load of poo. This stuff is about as thin as some Pleasure Max. This floor is going to get about 75 to like 80 mil worth of screed down on it, and it's important that when the screeders come in, they don't smash this sort of stuff about. Now, the screeders that are coming in today I know really, really well. I've done loads of work with them in the past, so no big deals there. Kev, I trust you. So what I'm saying is that what we've done, we've just put a spirit level across the top here, got our level, pop this on the wall nice and level, and now what we need to do is, I don't know if you noticed, but each one of my loops is tacked together, okay? And I just want to get this area cleared up so when our screeders come in later on, they can pretty much just get on with the job. Certain different types of manufacturers do certain different types of way of doing this. A lot of manufacturers will supply a curved bow that you can screw into a wall at the bottom, and that will protect the pipe as it comes up. You won't need to do this with butyline. Basically, just use your staples, get that down nice and tight. Make sure that when the guys come back later on, I often get a little bit of some of the blue ribbon that we have to protect the pipe there as well. So what I'm gonna do is pair off and split off each one of my pairs. Flying returns can go either way around, it's totally up to you. Just make sure you get your zones the right way around according to the sheet brief that I've got in my pocket. And obviously I know exactly which way around all these are at the moment. Double check as well. Just pace it out quickly and make sure you've got these the right way around before you start tying them all into here and getting these all cut back to length. So, I'm gonna do that now and then you can watch me get all these cut to length and put in. So there we go, a few weeks later and we're all done. We've got all of this in, we're all pressure tested. The actual way the system works, it was quite difficult for us to show in the video that we did a couple of weeks ago, but we've got a hot coming in the back here. It goes through this thermostatic valve, which currently is set at about 30 degrees at the want of the tilers who are working here at the moment. Our hot water gets through this pump here, along this top manifold. I mean, as you can see, everything goes nicely into the floor. It looks absolutely beautiful, really, really pleased with it. Let's have a quick look actually inside the kitchen itself. So then guys, there you go, all done, very echoey at the moment. I'm sure you can hear me okay. Look at that, beautiful. The tiles are down, the floor's been running at 30 degrees because that's what the tiles wanted to be. This place was absolutely baking. If we have a look at the floor, the screen has got fibres in it, but also we've got a separating membrane as well between the screen and the tiles, so if there is any cracking, there won't be any problems or deformities with the tiles as well. So there we go, that's how it's done. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Please do subscribe to us by clicking on the links appearing right now, and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and all the rest of it, and Snapchat. See you soon, guys. No time.